In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create messaging. So users can send messages to each other. They have their own messaging page where they receive messages, and this messaging works on website only. And you can allow them whether they can receive their message to email. So let's get started, and first this is our website WordPress where I'm showing you different examples which you can implement in your WordPress website. Let's start by that I will log into the website. This is root and this is what we created, and if you don't know how to install it, then go to my other tutorials where I'm showing you how to install WordPress on local environment and how to work with it. So once you are in administration in your website, we can start by going to pages, because we will need one page which will be in every user's profile dedicated for messaging. So let's go to pages and let's create add new. So we will create new page and we will call this page messaging. Just publish this page messaging or whatever. You can call this page however you want. And if you will now preview the site, like open link in new window, you will see here another tab messaging. And in next video probably I will show you how logged in users can see only pages, so these pages like this page messaging is not displayed all the time on your site. Only logged in users will be able to see this button messaging on their profiles. But this is not video about that. In this video we will create this messaging option so people can send messages whoever is logged in on your site to each other. Let's start by going to plugins then, and let's go to add new. Once we are in plugins, type in front end PM. Just write front end PM. It stands for front end personal messaging. This is the first plugin you will see here, front end PM. Just click on install now. Plugin actually allows all users to write messages to each other, and they have directory with other users and which you can hide, and you don't need to pay. There is a paid version as well, but you don't need, because this is more than enough. And after you have installed, then just click activate. It will activate that plugin, and you will see here on the left hand side front end PM. And like I mentioned, this plugin is more than enough for you. You don't even need to pay pro version or paid version, and this plugin allows you already to do so much things, as you will see in second. So now we go into settings. Here will be general, recipients, message, announcement, email, security and update. Let's go through these all so you understand what is going on here. Let's start with front end PM page. So here you can select page which will be the page for these messages of your users. So just click, and remember we just created this page messaging, just select that one. And before we continue, as you see, must have this tag. So we need to copy this tag into that page so it disappearing on that messaging page. So let's copy this and let's save these changes for now. And then let's go back to our website where we see this messaging page. Let's click into messaging. As you see, there is nothing at the moment. But let's click here on edit page. And let's paste this code into this page and let's update this page. And then when we open this page again, you see all messaging is already set, and you can remove these avatars if you don't like other people seeing these avatars and things like that by your basic settings of your application. We can send new message, and this is already allowing, and whenever you send messages you can allow you eat people even to send files, images, and you can remove that option if you don't want people to send each other files and images from this as well. So in message box here you will be able to preview all messages, so as you will be able to preview messages which you have sent and which you have received, so as you will be able to delete these messages. Then we have settings, and in these settings we have allow others to send me messages. This means that if you have this checked, others will be able to send messages to you. And second one is email me when I get a new message. This means that email will be sent to you to your email address which you have used when you have logged in into this website. So, and email me when new announcement is published. And this plugin also allows you to publish announcements. All users of your site who have registered are notified about these new announcements which you have published, or you can send announcements of groups of your users, for example only for subscribers or only for publishers. I will show you this a little bit later. And here is announcements page. This is clear enough, and here is directory, and in directory you will be able to see all users. As I have created this one site, as you see, currently I'm only root user because it's me and I can send message to myself, but why would I do it? Next thing what we will do, we will go to dashboard and let's create a new user. Let's go into users and here add new, and let's create some username like test, okay, some test user, and email I will give it whatever email I will give it, test for example at gmail, let's say gmail.com, okay. And first name if you want you can add, second name if you want you can add, and website is same. And I will give it simple password, like very easy, like something one Bugatti 123, let it be Bugatti 123. And then confirm use of weak password, okay. And then send user notification, send, I don't want to send because this email is not real, and he will be subscriber. And as you say, as I said, you guys, you can change here these roles, and then whenever you will send announcements you can decide to which role, particular role you want to user group to send this announcement. But I will leave it as subscriber and add new. So we have created another test user. And now if we will go back to our site, we will go into messages, and in this directory you will see that there are already two users. One is test user and one is me, which is currently logged in. And if I would want to send email to test user, I would just click send message. I am sending message to test, and here I can write subject if I want, and here I can write text if I want, and so on and so forth. So next let's return back to our front end plugin, to the settings page. Let's continue with messages to show per page. This is clear enough, you can change this amount if you want, and maximum user per page in directory. Directory is that place which I showed you just a second ago. This is this, how many users per page is in this directory displayed. If you would want to display there 50, you just change that number here. Next thing is time delay. Time delay is between messages sent, so you leave 5. Custom CSS if you want to implement, but I have been previously playing around with this plugin, and I find that it's easy to change CSS just by going into plugins and settings, and there you go to style sheet and change CSS for this plugin, or you open it from the backend, guys. Where is your all plugins installed for particular WordPress website. Leave this WordPress editor, this is okay. Parent message status publish and publish. This should be published, and here is the thing, allow attachments. And if you wouldn't want users to send each other attachments, you just uncheck this. If you want to allow them, then leave this checked. Then another thing, maximum number of attachments. This is how many attachments they can send. You can make bigger number, for example, if you would want to allow more than 4 files or 4 images to send to each other. Then next one is hide directory from front end. If you wouldn't want this directory tab to be displayed here, then you would need to check this, okay. And this says that always shown to admins. This means that if you are administrator of this particular website, or if there is more administrator users you have created with administrative permissions, then they will be able to preview even if you will hide this directory. But for example, test user who is not administrator but he has a role of subscriber, he will not be able to see this directory. Hide branding footer, and this is front-end PM, this branding. If you would want to hide it, you just check this, and obviously you would want to hide it and remove data or uninstall. This is obvious, guys. If you would uninstall this plugin, then this data will be deleted if this box will be checked. So let's save these changes. Let's go back, and you will see that if when I will restart this page, this front-end PM at the very bottom, it will disappear. Now we don't have that link to their website. This was general, and then we go to recipient. Yes, you can come around and have a look at these pro options, and let's go into messages. And this is like messages, how many messages can be displayed to all these, as you see, roles, administrator, editor, or author, and how many messages they can actually have in box at a time. If you would want, you can change it. Here at the top it says meshes box size 0 of 50. This means that only 50 messages per currently administrator latest messages will be stored on in his inbox. If I would want to change it to 50,000, there's no problem. For administrators, let's say 50,000 instead of 50. Okay, let's save these changes, and similar to all other roles of users. So now let's refresh this page. Now I can in my email get and save up to 50,000 messages, similar to all others like I mentioned. And then announcements, and about announcements per page, this is as well how many to show per page on announcements page. If this is this page on announcements page, how many announcements would be displayed there. Here as well, send email to all users who will receive these announcements. If you will check this, they will receive email as well to their email addresses which they have used when they have registered for your WordPress website. This is pretty much on this page, and I will show you all announcements and how to create announcement in a second, but let's finish this one. From email, it will be like you can here enter email from which they will be receiving announcement or emails, and here is from name. You just can add any names there, from, for example, your application's name, and so on and so forth. And here you check between, if you are going to send HTML emails, you check, select HTML. If you are going to send plain text emails, you just select plain text. And security is pretty much who can access message system. Like, you can select groups, for example. For some groups, you wouldn't want to allow this option to access messages, so you would uncheck them, and they wouldn't even see these messages, like, or messaging option on your website. All other thing, update is updates whenever this plugin will get some updates. So now let's go to all messages, and here you would be able to see all messages on your site which goes through this plugin, and all announcements. Here is all announcements which would you create. And to create announcement, you just click here new announcement, you give it a title, you give it some text or whatever you would want to do, and then you decide here, like I mentioned, on the right hand side to which user group you want to send. For example, if you would want to send this one announcement to only subscribers, you would check this before you click here publish, and after you have entered title of this announcement, and after you have entered like content, whatever you are going to tell all these users of this group, whether they are subscribers, contributors, authors, editors, or other administrators, or all of them. You can check all these groups if you would like. So yes, guys, this is pretty much about this plugin, how easily you can install it. And if you would want to change style of these buttons or disable these buttons, this is very easy, just by going to style sheet and rewriting some CSS and making style different if you don't like the style of these buttons. So yes, guys, if you found this video useful, leave a like, subscribe, share this video, and see you in my other videos.